There's actually so many memories of Geoffrey. Since I think I met him about 1994, and my kind of memories are like growing up with an academic, intellectually and kind of institutionally. We worked together on this Caesar kind of project, working together, and then sort of like collaborate, trying to build a community, but then also worked in the very much in the same space as it were in terms of like the theory methods and different areas. So yeah, it's difficult to isolate what was a kind of a collaboration over about 25 years in that space. And in many ways I think we were both what we kind of shared was a kind of desire to push the boundaries, to constantly kind of move things forward and not to do boring research, but actually to do research with a difference. And that was, I think that was one of the things that united us and sometimes divided us as well. So sometimes he would say, well, you know, and I remember. So some of my work was working with activists in informal or alternative kind of accounting situations. Geoffrey was very much let's look at the formal institution and look at that type of thing there. And we often had a discussion about whether what I was doing had anything to do with accounting at all. It was seminal. It was absolutely seminal work. I mean, I think he was one of the first scholars to look at the internet. You know, as at the time, most of their research was done on paper-based accounts, actual physical things. Whereas he was, I think, one of the first things he did. I think his PhD, his thesis was on it, was looking at the internet and the possibilities, what was happening there. What wasn't happening there, what was being done differently, and how it all connected together. So opening up that space, but then looking at some of his research, particularly some of the stuff I think on methods, on how to do research properly. So he made a seminal contribution in methods. And he also did a lot of introduced new kind of like advanced theory on quite a bit. Particularly, I think some of his work with alternate conceptions of risk, the sociology of risk, was a really important stuff. And then he also stepped into NGOs and opened up another area of types of accountability in that. And he was also a kind of a leader. So I think one of the things that marked him out was he did a lot of state of the nation type plenaries where he was able to understand, because he had this broad, he was able to look at the broad arc of how things were developing and identifying particular position points and then looking at different futures and different ways forward, which is there.